Hey, my name is Sarah Nadia. I'm new to YouTube. I love YouTube, but I'm new. I've never made my own videos. I made a feeble attempt just recently, but never made anything that went anywhere, and I would love to see how it would work out for me if I tried. I don't know much about editing or making videos, but I guess I'll figure it out as I go, or maybe I won't, and I'll cease to post. But for now, excuse me. Well, I love YouTube. There are so many people that I love, and I love to hear their voices, and I love to hear their stories, and their vlogs, and I thought maybe I'd make an attempt at making my own. Right now, I am going to try and read you a short story, and I'm going to read the first section and see how it goes. If I get a lot of comments, if I get people going, yay, we like your stuff, and then I'll continue to post, and if I don't get much of a response, if it's not going anywhere, then maybe I won't continue to post, but just a little background on me. I love the, and I think I've said love way too much already, but I love all the meditation videos, the relaxation videos, the guided meditation videos, the whisper videos. I love the whisper videos. Whispering Life, she's great. She's wonderful. If you haven't checked her out, you should, because she will push you to sleep, and you will stay there. So yeah, that's a little introduction on me. On YouTube, I like to go by Sarah Nadia, and you can contact me through here. I'm going to start by reading the Hans Christian Andersen story, The Little Match Seller, and we'll see how it goes, okay? All right, see you in a minute. Bye. So, here we go with chapter 1 of The Little Match Seller by Hans Christian Andersen. It was a terribly cold and nearly dark, the last evening of the old year, and the snow was falling fast. In the cold and the darkness, a poor little girl with a bare head and naked feet roamed through the streets. It is true. She had on a pair of slippers when she left home, but they were not much. They were very large, so large indeed, that they had belonged to her mother, and the poor little creature had lost them, running across the street to avoid two carriages that were rolling. Say that he could use it as a writer when he had children of his own. So the little girl went on with her naked little feet, which were quite red and blue in the cold. In an apron, she carried a number of matches and had a bundle of them in her hands. No one hunger. She crept along. Poor little child. She looked at the picture of misery. The snowflakes fell on her fair, long hair, which hung in curls on her shoulders. But she regarded them not. lights were shining from every window, and there was a savory smell of a roast goose, for it was New Year's Eve. Yes, she remembered that. In a corner between two houses, one of which projected beyond the other, she sank down and huddled herself together. She had drawn on her little feet under, but she could not keep off the goat, and she dared not go on, for she had so no matches and could not take home even a penny of money. Almost as cold at home as it was here, for they had only a roof to cover them, through which the wind howled. Although the largest house had been stocked up with straw in rags, her little hands, were almost frozen with the cold. Ah, perhaps a burning be some good if she could draw it from the bundle, strike it against the wall, just to warm her fingers.